One day, huh? Mm-hmm. One day, the whole earth will sing the praises of God.
Two children, because I have 26 great-grandchildren, which is really nice, but but the, in addition to that, I have the best church family ever, and also the Lord provided us with youth group kids that have really stuck by us, and there's about four of them that particularly, four girls that literally they think I'm their mother, and I feel like I am too. Some of them lost their mother when they were younger. And anyway, one of them was able to come down this week. She worked the whole day. I mean, it was 100 and something, and she was outside working. trying to take care of things that needed to be taken care of. So I'm blessed by that, and I'm also blessed by Cindy next to me, and, who the church can always rely on her. And right now, I'm relying on her. She, you know, she's agreed to be my follow-up and take, you know, if I need something. And that is kind of really important to me because we're out there in what most people call nowhere land. But anyway, I just thank the Lord for all these things. And he's been good to us.
He provided you a family. You know that you did. You're surrounded, and you've affected so many young
She's
people.
She's got a huge family of her own.
You've got children by proxy.
Yes, exactly.
It's amazing. Praise the Lord. And you're such a blessing.
Well, thank you. God is good. All because of him.
Josh.
I'd just like to thank my mom and dad and my sis and my brother. They're always there for me and always in my corner when I can be a real pill. So.
And I appreciate you, man. Every time I see you, it's always smiles and hugs. It's such a good culture to family here.
I just praise God for the family here we have too. It's so neat to have your people that you see once a week. They're so close.
Are you gonna go to the phone?
Well, kids club. Yay! There they go.
Walk.
Or run slowly or walk. Yeah. Walk slowly. Walk.
Skid to a stop, then walk.
Red light, green light. Oh, that was fantastic, Anthony.
Amen.
Thank you.
That was great.
I'll never look at a duck the same after that. No. Seven ducks, that's fantastic. Yeah.
One duck.
Wow. How long did you feast? For 7 days?
Yeah.
All right, that's fantastic. God is good. He meets every need that we have. As we are obedient to his voice and do what he tells us to do. You cannot go wrong. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. You get out, you trust in the Lord with all your heart. You lean not unto your own senses, knowing that God is who he says he is, was, and is forever, and that he will be true to his word. Amen?
Amen.
You can take his word to the bank, spiritual bank, physical bank, whatever you need, he's there and he'll meet it. However, he'll work a miracle. Like we say all the time, all things are possible to him that believes. And we today as a church believe his promise. We believe his promises. We believe the promise of the promised one. We believe in the promised one, and that's Jesus Christ. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Jesus has not lost his power. In fact, he said, I have the power, but I'm giving it to my church. And do you realize how much power you have stored up on the inside of you? Because you are the temple of the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. And whatever you ask in my name, he says, I will do it according to my will. So there's power there. You're asking, you're believing, and I believe every person here that prays in line with the word of God will get exactly what they prayed to God for. Amen?
Amen.
Be on the lookout. It's time to be on the lookout for that miracle.
Amen.
Amen? Keep your eyes focused. Keep them. Stay clear-headed. Don't let discouragement and depression cloud your mind to where you feel frustrated and angry and full of anxiety, and you just don't, and you have this feeling that you don't know what to do. That's why you're in church today, to refocus and stay on point. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Keep living your life for Jesus. Keep being obedient to his voice, and look out for what he's planning to do in the days to come in your life. Amen?
Amen.
The world is in turmoil, but you don't have to be. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
In this world, you have tribulation, but he says, be of good cheer. I have overcome the world. Amen?
Amen.
And he says, whoever comes to me, I will not turn away, because my yoke is easy and my burden is light. So in the midst of the chaos, in the midst of the confusion, and in the midst of the political scheme or whatever is going on in the world, you can be calm as a cucumber.
Amen.
I don't know what calm as a cucumber means, but that's a good saying. You can be cool. You can be at ease. You can be stable. You can be consistent. You can be focused. Hallelujah. Psalms 23 says, verse 23, verse 4 says, yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. The Amplified says, even though I walk through the sunless valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for you are with me. You do not have to fear. In life, things come up against you, but they're only a shadow. The enemy says the thief comes to steal, kill, and destroy. The enemy says does he ever put thoughts in your mind? The enemy?
Oh,
says, yeah. Oh, you're not going to make it.
Yeah.
Oh, that ache and pain, it's going to get you. This financial hardship, you're not going to get through it. There's no way you can get all these things done because you don't have the help you need. You ever put those thoughts in your mind and you feel you start getting tired and you start feeling, oh, Lord Jesus, and then that discouragement and that depression. But then you realize you heard a good news sermon that, hey, you serve a God that can do anything, and that he lives on the inside of you. And then, yea, though you walk through the valley of shadow of death, you don't have to fear that evil. It's a shadow. It's a shadow that says, oh, I'm going to destroy you. I'm going to hurt you. I'm going to overpower you. But I want to tell you, that's just a shadow. If you're walking along and the sun's shining and you see your shadow, can your shadow rise up off the ground and beat you up?
No,
it can't. Yeah, and David said the same thing. I'm going through all these troubles, but they're just a shadow, just an empty shell. They cannot harm me, because yea, though I go through the valley of shadow, then he penned that, I will fear no evil, for he is with me. Though the enemy surrounds me, in this will I be confident. One thing have I desired, that will I seek after, that I may dwell in the house of the Lord. Because in his presence I have fullness of joy, and I am encompassed with a cloud of witnesses. I trust in the Lord, so I'm surrounded by angels. No evil will befall me, or any plague can come my dwelling, because I serve the Lord. And those words ring true. Yea, though I walk through this valley, I'm going to go through this valley, and I'm coming to the other side, because I'm going to see the sun shine. Amen?
Amen.
And not the S-U-N, but the S-O-N, that light that shines in the darkness of our lives and brings life, health, and liberty, and freedom. Amen?
Amen.
You can walk out of here today feeling light as a feather, be free as a bird, knowing that those chains in life, those things that are compassing you about, cannot hold you down, because you know the truth, and the truth has set you free. Because that anointing that abides in you is Jesus Christ, the hope of glory, that anointed one. He lives in you, and that the Bible says that anointing breaks every yoke. It breaks every chain. And that's the Spirit of the Lord. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. We don't walk powerless. We're not a wimpy, weak, watered down, lukewarm Christian that has no power, but we have the same Spirit that raised Christ from the dead, that lives and moves and abides in us. Amen?
Amen?
So whatever you're facing today, you've got the victory. You have the victory. Whatever situation you're facing, God will always cause you to triumph through Jesus Christ.
Amen.
You serve Jesus.
Yeah.
Are you obedient to his voice?
Yes.
Are you walking in love?
Yes.
Whoa. Do you have faith in God?
Yes.
Are you putting action to your faith?
Yes.
Well, you are the candidate, prime candidate. You are on the list for that miracle that you're believing for.
Amen.
Amen? Yes. So you can be confident. You can step before God boldly and in confidence. You can step, the Bible says you can come before the throne of God boldly with confidence. Amen?
Amen.
Full assurance that what God said he would do, he will do. So if you're walking through a dire circumstance or situation, my Bible says it's only a shadow, and that shadow cannot harm you and cannot beat you up. Amen?
Amen.
The only thing that can beat you up, beat you down, is those thoughts that bombard your mind, and that you have to rise up. And the Bible says we don't war against flesh and blood, but we war against principalities, powers, rulers of darkness, and all spiritual wickedness. But we cast down those imaginations that exalt itself against the knowledge and authority of the Word of God, because all those things are just shadows and they cannot harm you. Amen?
Amen.
Because greater is he that's in you than he that's in the world. What's our job until then? Well, the Bible says in Exodus 14, it says, I'm going to read Amplified, or King James first, the Lord shall fight for you, and you shall hold your peace. Don't be grumbling, don't be griping, don't be complaining, don't be negative, all right? You acknowledge the problem, but we don't have to acknowledge the problem. We don't deny the problem, but we don't have to acknowledge the problem 10, 15, 20 times. Amen? You should talk about the goodness and the greatness and the glory of God. And that should be, the word of God should be in your mouth and a two-edged sword in your hand. Amen? You need to march up and take everything that God has given you, because he's fighting the battle going before you. So the Bible says here in Exodus 14:14 in the Amplified, the Lord will fight for you while you only need to keep silent and remain calm.
Amen.
Whatever you face this week, remain calm. Don't lose your cool. Have I lost my cool this week? Oh yes, I have. But I have to come back to the altar of grace and mercy and apply the blood of Jesus. Amen?
Amen.
Just like we all do. And I'm talking about the goodness of God, the faithfulness of God, and that yea, though you walk through the valley of the shadow of death, you do not have to fear any evil. Isaiah 26. The thing we want to do in those hard times, realize they're just a shadow that God's going to bring you through as you put your faith and hope and trust in him. We want to enter into that peace in the meantime. Isaiah 26 verse 3 says, thou will keep him in perfect peace whose mind is stayed on thee because he trusts thee. Amplified, you will keep him perfect. You will keep in perfect and constant peace the one whose mind is steadfast, that is committed and focused on you in both inclination and character. Amen. Through those times we realize we go through the valley of the shadow of death, David said, I don't have to fear any evil. What did he have? He had peace. The peace that passes in all understanding and guards our heart and mind in him. Amen. And today I would like each and every one of you just to realize how important. I want each and every one of you to have peace. Perfect peace in whatever you're going through. Knowing that God is in control. Amen?
Amen.
Keep your trust in him. Trusting in him. Because if you're full of anxiety, full of distress, full of confusion, you can't hear God clearly. And it's easier for you to get off track. Because in Colossians chapter 3, verse 15, Colossians 3, verse 15, it says, peace of Christ, the inner calm of one who walks daily with him, be the controlling factor in your hearts, deciding and settling questions that arise. To this peace, indeed, you were called as members in one body of believers, and be thankful to God always. That's what we did at the beginning of the service. We thank God for everything he's doing. Amen?
Amen.
But it says right here, let the peace of Christ, the inner calm of one who walks daily with him, be the controlling factor in your hearts, deciding and settling questions that arise. I want you to be led by the Lord. How does he lead you? He leads you by his peace. It starts with walking through a valley, walking through trials and situations and circumstances, knowing that many are the afflictions of the righteous, but also says the Lord delivers us from them. Amen?
Amen.
As we're walking through them, we want to let all that anger, frustration, irritation go, come to the foot of the cross, cast all our cares on him, and allow that peace that passes all understanding to guard our hearts and minds, and allow him to see us through whatever we're going through. Because if we make decisions under pressure and not have the peace about it, there's chances are we can get off track. But we're not going to get off track, amen? Because you're hearing the word of God. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
That peace, let it be the controlling factor. First, you know you're going through something. That's life. You're having to deal with things. That's life. But you do not have to be ruled by those circumstances and situations. You can allow God to fight your battle, and you can stay at rest, and you can be calm.
Amen.
Amen?
Amen.
And as you're peaceful, and you come into that place where his yoke is easy and his burden is light, that spirit of rest and peace on you, you're open, and you can be led accordingly, and God can take you from where you are to where he wants you to be. Amen.
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 All right?
Yes.
Hallelujah. Two more scriptures. Philippians. We already know this one. Philippians 4:6 says, be careful for nothing, but in everything by prayer and supplication, with thanksgiving, let your requests be known unto God. Verse 6, and Amplified, do not be anxious or worried about anything, but in everything, every circumstance and situation, by prayer and petition, with thanksgiving, continue to make your specific requests known to God. And the peace of God, that peace which reassures the heart, that peace which transcends all understanding, that peace which stands guard over your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus, is yours. Amen? It is yours. As you're walking with him, realizing you're going through a valley, some of us, maybe some of us are on the mountaintop. Oh, I'm so happy for you. That is fantastic. But hey, you can just save this message for later. But if you're going through the valley, the things you're facing, you don't deny them, but you realize they have no power over you because you are a child of God. Your trust and your faith and your hope is in him. You enter into that peace, and through that peace, he leads and guides you to that place where he wants you to be and the things he wants you to do. Amen.
Amen.
John 14. John 14, 27. John 14. Jesus, this is Jesus talking. He's got you in the palm of his hands. Isn't that good to know? Amen? Praise God. Jesus said, peace I leave with you. My perfect peace I give to you. Not as the world gives do I give unto you. Do not let your heart be troubled, nor let it be afraid. Let my perfect peace calm you in every circumstance, and give you courage and strength for every challenge. I'm going to read that one more time. Peace I leave with you. My perfect peace I give to you. Not as the world gives, give I unto you. Today, do not let your heart be troubled, nor let it be afraid. Let my perfect peace calm you in every circumstance, and give you courage and strength for every challenge. Let my perfect peace calm you in every circumstance and give you courage and strength for every challenge. Amen.
Amen.
I believe the Lord is with you today. He's given you strength that even at this very moment. The peace of God that passes all understanding is guarding your heart and mind. And as you choose and you reach out to Him, you can settle in that and move with that and see Him do great and mighty things. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. In this world, you'll have trouble, but Jesus said, "Be of good cheer. I have overcome the world for you."
Woo!
Praise God. Give Jesus a hand clap. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus, for every person here today. Thank you for moving and ministering. I know it's not by power, not by might. It's by your Spirit. Holy Spirit, I thank you for reigning supreme in each one, each person's life here today. I thank you, Lord, our battles are not ours, but yours, and we can be calm and be at peace and be at rest. Thank you for moving mightily on the behalf of every person here today. Thank you. Thank you. I appreciate it. I just give you all the glory. I give you all the honor. And I put my trust and my faith totally in you today, as everyone here else does too. In Jesus' name, and everyone said, Amen.
Amen.
Amen.